behalf of all of the presidents of the colleges and universities in the state of Ohio and all of our faculty and staff and our students, we'd like to thank Representative Anielski for her leadership, the entire legislation for getting behind this tremendous initiative. We appreciate the governor's backing of all that we'll be able to do with this. And it really was startling as Representative Anielski read some of the stark realities and just to see what a difficult situation we have for our young people. And Marquis, if I can make sure I can get a copy of her slides, because I think everyone at my university needs to know those things. But you know, I think back to having worked with college-aged youngsters for the last 42 years. And we tried to make sure we follow one edict. And the edict was a quote that we had on our wall of our staff room that was attributed to Albert Einstein. And the quote was, "Concern for man and his fate must form the chief interest of all technical endeavors. Never forget this in the midst of your diagrams and equations." And so if you think about the world I was in for a long time, we had lots of diagrams and equations. As you think about a university, there are lots of diagrams and equations and academic things that we want our young people to absorb. But our chief interest has got to be the concern for our young people and their faith. And that's why this is such a tremendous opportunity for all of us in higher education to be reminded that we need these best practices in place. We need to make sure that our students know that there are resources and that we are here for them. You know, as I think about a long lifetime in higher education, and as time goes on, it seems like it's become a little bit more of a divisive world. This group doesn't get along with that group, and this group, it doesn't seem like we collaborate as much as we should. And this is so much fun to see the entire governing body in Ohio behind this and all of the universities. And one of the other things we all seem to agree upon over the years is that when we think back to that World War II era, everyone seems to agree that that was the greatest generation. And they think about everyone just dropped whatever it was they were doing and banded together in an effort because extraordinary things were going on in the world. Therefore, they were deemed the greatest generation. As I think about my generation and the people just a little bit younger, in some ways I think of us as being the luckiest generation because we've had the good fortune of what so many have done before us, and it's just been a wonderful time in a lot of ways. And I think of this young generation now perhaps as the most vulnerable generation. What they face in terms of all of the, whether it be Instagram or email or cell phones or instant things going back and forth, the pressures, and there was a young guy I'm going to introduce to you in just a second that we'll share with you a little bit about that, but the pressures on our young people today, the view that they have in some cases that there isn't a great deal of hope for their dreams. This is a vulnerable time, and for us to have this opportunity to have this House Bill 28 initiative, and to us to be challenged to make sure that our concern is for our students and their faith, that's our chief interest, is a great opportunity for us right now. I'd like to introduce to you a young guy who's kind of our